After an extraordinary journey covering the Olympics in Pyeongchang, South Korea, Cheryl Preheim is officially back with us here in Atlanta and 11Alive. She joins us right now in studio to share some of her favorite moments from an experience that you will carry with you the rest of your life.
It was a wonderful month. We were gone about 26 days, got back on Tuesday.
Time.
It's so good to be back to see all. I've missed everybody here. I've missed my family,
missed
too.
We missed you so much here.
Thank you. What an extraordinary trip, though. And I think the thing that really stands out to me is just the people of South Korea, both in Seoul, which is a huge city, 22 million people, and then Pyeongchang, which is a much smaller community. People were so friendly. It was very cold, and we'd be standing outside for long periods of time in the cold, and strangers would come up and offer us hot tea to try to warm us up. Or you'd be walking around carrying a lot of television equipment, and people would just offer to try to help you carry a bag.
What is the most searing memory, do you think, 10 or 15 years from now? Is it the environment of South Korea, being there, or is it the athletes, or is it a combination of both?
It is a combination of both. I will never forget the moment standing on the line between North and South Korea,
yeah,
and learning more about the history of those two countries, about the time that border was established, and what has happened since. It was a very personal experience for me as I looked into North Korea, and I thought to myself, there are 25 million people, as I stare in that direction, who have no access to television, to internet, to any information other than what their government wants them to have to support its own narrative.
Too.
Yeah. And to say, gosh, especially in the profession we are, to be able to be in a profession where it is wanted and expected that we would hold the powerful accountable. So that was really, really striking to me. And then also to follow the athletes who don't make a fortune,
right,
aren't famous, do it purely for the passion and the love of it, and are so proud to represent their country, and then they share it with us, and what an honor to get to stand at a finish line and see them in the moment that they have accomplished a dream.
There is a purity about winter athletes because, you know, they don't have any recruiters waiting on them offering vast sums of money. There's
right.
No NBA, there's no Major League Baseball or the NFL. This is everything to them, and it will in large part define their life's journey thereafter.
Yeah, they are hard workers who set a goal, determined to reach it at great personal cost and financial cost. Many of them have had to raise their own money, work a second job as
right.
they're training, and do it purely because they love it. And what it has meant to them to have all of you join them and cheer them on and watch them and encourage them, it means the world to them that the country gets behind them at this time.
Do you have a favorite athlete?
Well, I have to tell you, I was very partial to our Georgia athletes. Chris Kinney, who is an extraordinary young man, and I think you'll see him at many more Olympics, just a renaissance man, such a good person and a hard worker. He was terrific. And then getting to know Alana Myers-Taylor was a treat as well. She is just as down-to-earth as you can imagine, and to see her succeed and get a silver medal meant a lot.
And she may come back again. There may be no end to her career.
She's already talking about it. She's set on the next 4 years.
Cheryl, it's great to have you back.
Thank
Please,
you.
As much as we love your work with the Olympics, 4 years from now, stay here with us.
Okay.
Okay.
It's good to see you. My two-year-old's over there on the couch, so I'll go chat with him here in a little bit,
he
too.
He's so cute. All right. We'll see you next week.
Thank you.
Certainly great to have Cheryl back.